Hello learners, welcome to this session. In this session, let us have a discussion on tools and technologies for development of information systems. We cover past as well as future technologies. So in the earlier session, we have seen the development of information system. In that, we had seen several methodologies how to develop the information system. For the last several decades, system development keeps evolving and the technological tools that enable system development are evolving as well. The use of computer-aided software engineering tools called as CASE were the more promising tools for all phases of the system development lifecycle. So in your course content, there was a context of discussion of computer-aided software engineering tools. So I am Professor V.V. Subramaniam, Director, School of Computer Information Sciences, IGNO, New Delhi. Let us focus on case tools, which were the past technologies, and then what are the future technologies that are going to happen. So these include data modeling tools. The case tools includes data modeling tools, analysis and design specification tools, user interface prototyping tools, and code generator tools. The large scale SDLC development work involved the use of case tools. So in this video, both past and future tools and technologies for the development of information systems will be discussed. So let us concentrate on past tools and technologies for the development of information systems. So during 1980s, 90s, major software companies, they used to procure the CASE tools. So full form of CASE is computer aided software engineering tools. They were widespread in 80s and 90s. They can be defined as the automation of part of or the entire systems development process. Major corporate companies used to have these CASE tools. These tools are computer based products that support one or more phases within the software development life cycle. These tools help reduce or eliminate many of the design and development programs inherent in projects produced by manual methods. There are integrated CASE tools, like you can call it in short ICASE, front-end tools, those can be called as upper CASE, and back-end tools, those are called as lower CASE tools. So let us see the scope of CASE tools. There are several CASE tools. Some will come as standalone things and some will be the part of a complete integrated package. Diagram tools are there, process modeling tools, process management tools, documentation tools, analysis tools, configuration management tools, change control tools, programming control tools, prototyping tools, web development tools, quality assurance tools, and maintenance tools. So there are wide variety of packages available, and these will come as the part of a package, or else individual companies sell the standalone products and later on will be integrated into the system of CASE tools that are existing with the client company. So use of CASE tools, it reduces the amount of time and money spent on projects. It improves the quality of the systems developed. It enhances the developer's productivity and satisfaction, make the system development task more enjoyable, and CASE tools enable the developing of systems that are easier to test and maintain and contain good quality of documentation. In a nutshell, software developed using CASE tools have improved quality due to fewer defects. Designers can input the requirements of a system and the CASE tool can generate the code, and this is called as forward engineering. CASE tool also supports the reverse engineering, wherein which the existing code from legacy systems can be turned into design specifications which in turn can be used to restructure the code and ultimately the system to meet the new business needs. With the advent of object-oriented methodologies being incorporated into case tools, inexperienced or even non-programmers are able to utilize case tools due to the simplicity of object-oriented languages. So let us talk about the case environment. A case environment can be defined as a collection of case tools and other related components together with an integrated approach that supports most of the interactions that occur among the components and the environment. A case environment includes a number of case tools that operate on a common hardware and software platform. You can call this particular case environment as a case suite also, because it is the integration of so many tools, either they may be related or else they may be the part of the package. One example we can quote here is Rational Suite version 2002, in which it is a package of dozen or so tools that focus on separate aspects of software development. So the examples of case tools, there are so many packages available earlier. During 1980s and 90s, there were several packages, that too very standard and popular packages. As we talked about, during 2002, Rational Rose was very much popular. Likewise, there are several packages which you can see. One is the Analyst Design Toolkit, Automate Plus, Case 2000, Accelerator, Information Engineering Workbench, Teamwork, DEFT Deft, Oracle Star Case, Simple Case. And the suite includes Request Pro, like the Rational Rose suite of 2002, version 2002 includes Request Pro, which looks after the requirements management, Rational Rose, which looks after the UML modeling, Clear Case is another package, which looks after the version management, ClearQuest, which looks after the defect and change management, Test Manager, Development Studio, and it contains the quality assurance tools, and Rational Robot, which is a testing automator. So these are some of the components of the Rational Rose 2002. So let us discuss on limitations of case tools also. As these packages are very expensive, most of the small companies can't afford. There were potential limitations associated with the use of case tools. Training and education of users can take considerable time, and the cost of training can be much, as $1 for every dollar invested in the case tool itself. So apart from the cost of the package, the training also incurs so much of cost. Once purchased, the tool will require upgrades, patches, ongoing usage, and maintenance fees. The simple evaluation process used for selecting a case tool will also take time. If not planned for ahead of time, inadequate integration with other tools or components of the system reduces productivity and requires time for integration work. Last but not the least, case tools can be expensive. Many organizations believe that the cost of case tools along with associated hardware costs can only be justified for large-scale development. So case tools that were introduced before mid-90s support traditional methodologies or do not fully incorporate the methodology. New set of case tools that supported UML diagrams were introduced after 1997, and some of the currently available tools also support agile development as well as model-driven engineering and XUML. Later on, these case tools lost their importance. There are several open source packages available, or else rapid application development tools has come into force, or else there are several tools and technologies in isolation has come, wherein which they were designed only meant for one purpose, and then after the usage of that particular tool, another tool may be available in the open source which can be used in order to look into the things. So keeping the past ahead, let us see the future tools and technologies for the development of information systems. So one technology we can always talk about is the autonomous things. Autonomous things such as robots, drones, and autonomous vehicles use artificial intelligence to automate functions previously performed by the humans. Their automation goes beyond the automation provided by rigid programming models, and they exploit artificial intelligence to deliver advanced behaviors that interact more naturally with their surroundings and with the people. So as autonomous things proliferate, we expect a shift from standalone intelligent things to a swarm of collaborative intelligent things with multiple devices working together, either independently of people or with little human input. For example, if a drone examined a large field and found that it was ready for harvesting, it could dispatch an autonomous harvester. Or in the delivery market, the most effective solution may be to use an autonomous vehicle to move packages to the target area. Robots and drones on board the vehicle could then ensure final delivery of the package. The second thing that we can talk about the technology part is the augmented analytics. Augmented analytics focuses on a specific area of augmented intelligence using machine learning to transform how analytics content is developed, consumed, and shared. Augmented analytics capabilities will advance rapidly to mainstream adoption as a key feature of data preparation, data management, modern analytics, business process management, process mining, and data science platforms. Automated insights from augmented analytics will also be embedded in enterprise applications. For example, those of the human resource department, finance, sales, marketing, customer service, procurement, and asset management departments to optimize the decisions and actions of all employees within their context, not just those analysts and data scientists. Augmented analytics automates the processes of data preparation, insight generation, and insight visualization, eliminating the need for professional data scientists in many situations. So the next thing we can talk about is the artificial intelligence driven development. So all these things, like whatever we are talking about earlier, all these things contain the artificial intelligence component. So basically that is the spinal cord working behind each and every information system that will be coming in future. So advanced artificial intelligence powered development environments automating both functional and non-functional aspects of applications will give rise to a new age of citizen application developer, where non-professionals will be able to use artificial intelligence driven tools to automatically generate new solutions. So tools that enable non-professionals to generate applications without coding are not new, but we expect that AI powered systems will drive a new level of flexibility. So there is another technology which is becoming popular, that is the digital twins. A digital twin refers to the digital representation of a real world entity or a real world system. One aspect of the digital twin evolution that moves beyond Internet of Things will be enterprises implementing digital twins of their organizations, which in short called as the DTO. A DTO is a dynamic software model that relies on operational or other data to understand how an organization operationalizes its business model, connects with current state, deploys resources, and responds to changes to deliver expected customer value. DTOs help drive efficiencies in business processes as well as create more flexible, dynamic, and responsive processes that can potentially react to changing conditions automatically. There is another word which is becoming very popular, that is the edge computing. We were hearing from past decade the applications of cloud computing. So this is one computing methodology which comes under the extension of the cloud computing. The edge refers to endpoint devices used by people or embedded in the world around us. Edge computing describes a computing topology in which information processing and content collection and delivery are placed closer to these endpoints. Earlier, it used to travel till the point of cloud and then the response needs to be sent. There was a latency when we talk about the cloud. Nowadays, it is in the form of edge computing. The services are very much near, or the processing is happening very much nearer to the devices. It tries to keep the traffic and processing local, with the goal being to reduce traffic and latency. Over the next 5 years, specialized artificial intelligence chips, along with greater processing power, storage, and other advanced capabilities will be added to a wider way of edge devices. The extreme heterogeneity of this embedded Internet of Things world and the long life cycles of assets such as industrial systems will create significant management challenges. So longer term, as 5G matures, the expanding edge computing environment will have more robust communication back to centralized services. So 5G provides lower latency, higher bandwidth, and very importantly for the edge, a dramatic increase in the number of nodes, those are called as the edge endpoints, per every square kilometer. So another technology that we can talk about, this is not one, maybe three technologies we can talk about, which are very much interrelated and very near to each other. One is the virtual reality, augmented reality, and the mixed reality. Conversational platforms are changing the way in which people interact with the digital world. Virtual reality, augmented reality, and mixed reality are changing the way in which people perceive the digital world. This combined shift in perception and interaction model leads to the future immersive user experience. So there is another technology which is budding up, that is called as the blockchain technology. Blockchain, it is a type of distributed ledger, promises to reshape industries by enabling trust, providing transparency, and reducing friction across business ecosystems, potentially lowering costs, reducing transaction settlement times, and improving cash flow. Today, trust is placed in banks, clearinghouses, government, and many other institutions as general authorities with the single version of the truth maintained securely in their databases. Blockchain provides an alternative trust mode and removes the need for central authorities in arbitrating transactions. So there are certain smart spaces that we can talk about. What is a smart space? It is a physical or a digital environment in which humans and technology-enabled systems interact in increasingly open, connected, coordinated, and intelligent ecosystems. So multiple elements, including people, processes, services, and things, come together in a smart space to create a more immersive, interactive, and automated experience for a target set of people and industry scenarios. This trend has been coalescing for some time around elements such as smart cities, digital workplaces, smart homes, and connected factories. The market is entering a period of accelerated delivery of robust smart spaces, with technology becoming an integral part of our daily lives, whether as employees, customers, consumers, community members, or citizens. So there is another thing, maybe in next 3 to 4 years, which will be very much popular, that is the quantum computing. Quantum computing, in short, you can call it as QC, It is a type of non-classical computing that operates on the quantum state of subatomic particles, for example, electrons or ions, that represent information as elements denoted as quantum bits. These quantum bits are also called as the QU bits. The parallel execution and exponential scalability of quantum computers means they excel with problems too complex for a traditional approach, or where a traditional algorithms would take too long to find a solution. Industries such as automotive, financial, insurance, pharmaceuticals, military, and research organizations have the most to gain from the advancements of quantum computing. So, here in this particular session, we had covered the tools and technologies, those were past as well as future. We started our discussion with the introduction of case tools, that is, computer assisted software engineering tools, where in which those particular packages were very much popular in 80s and 90s. In your course material also, there is a talk about the case tools. So that is the reason we had covered the case tools from the past category. And then what are the tools and technologies that are going to come in future? We had seen many technologies, and each and every technology you can see artificial intelligence is the spinal cord or else power behind the tools and technologies that we are going to have it in future. Hope you had understood this particular session, and in the next session we will talk about the maintenance and updating of information systems. Thank you. Happy learning.